Okay, Shivam. So first of all, thanks for your time you gave to me today for this recording this session, and also yes. Congratulations for getting selected in direct PhD in IIT Delhi for in Applied Mechanics Department.
Thank you, sir.
And Shivam, you know IIT Delhi direct PhD is a hard nut to crack. IIT Delhi mein direct PhD mein normally wo students ko lete nahi the pehle. Now they have started taking, and it's really difficult from BTech to PhD, and that is what you have done. So it is a really good achievement. So now I want you Shivam to tell us something about your credentials. Aapne graduation kab kiya, which branch, which college, CGPA, GATE score, and your category, this information first.
So sir, my full name is Shivam Singh Tomar, and I am from Lucknow city, sir. I did my BTech from SRM Institute of Science and Technology, Chennai. So sir, my CGPA till the 6th semester is of 9.16. Now the 8th semester has been done, so cumulative CGPA will come in few days. And sir, I'm from mechanical engineering background, but I wrote my GATE exam in aerospace engineering, and I got the score of 509, sir.
509, you got with aerospace, huh?
Yes, sir.
And what is your category, Shivam?
Sir, general.
Okay. So Shivam, why you wrote with aerospace if you're a mechanical engineer?
Sir, I got interested into the field, like mostly into fluid mechanics. I have also applied the for applied mechanics department in fluid mechanics. So like in aerospace,
you could have written with XE also, no?
Sir, that time XE information was like not that much available to me. So I just like saw the compressible flows and fluid mechanics and potential flow. So that was like the overall of fluid mechanics. So I went with aerospace, and okay. Only one new subject was there, flight mechanics. So it was easy.
So Shivam, you have 9 plus CGPA and 500 plus GATE score. The meaning of that is you will get multiple calls from MTech, MS, PhD. If you have applied, majority from PhD yes. and MS courses. So can you tell me from where you got the calls with these credentials?
Yes, sir. For MS, IIT Palakkad, and for
keep
PhD.
Keep telling the course also. I mean, thermal, mechanical. Kahan se?
Yeah, sir. In IIT Palakkad, actually thermal MS, PhD in IIT Ropar and Gandhinagar, both thermal and fluid. Then IIT Bombay Aerospace, IIT Kanpur Aerospace, and IIT Delhi Applied Mechanics.
IIT Bombay में आपको MS से आया था कॉल, राइट?
नहीं सर,
PhD. ओके ओके. एंड हाउ मेनी प्लेसेस यू हैड द इंटरव्यू शिवम?
सर, आई गेव इंटरव्यू फॉर 3, 4, 6 प्लेसेस, एंड आल्सो सर आईआईटी गुवाहाटी, MS एनर्जी.
MS का भी कॉल आया.
यस सर.
अच्छा शिवम, अब मेरे को प्लीज टेल मी अबाउट दिस द सिलेक्शन दैट इज IIT Delhi direct PhD, इसका इंटरव्यू कैसा हुआ था? What do you think is the criteria of their selection?
Sir, first of all, तो they asked for like they asked us to fill a Google form. In that, they asked us to show our work, like what you have published. So in second year, I had a one conference paper, and in my final year project also, I published a paper. It's still in publication, sir. So I just mentioned like what all I did. And in the link which they asked, like DOI is there, so I just mentioned it's about to publish. So that was there, and then they asked for your area of interest. So in that I mentioned compressible flows, aerodynamics, reverse engineering was one topic. So I mentioned all this, sir.
And how
so
important then, it is, sir, to go ahead?
Yeah, sir. Then with this, I guess. They set the criteria for shortlisting of PhD 9.5 CGPA, I guess. Sorry, sir, 7.5 CGPA.
Okay, okay.
Nine. Yeah,
no, I don't think 7.5. मेरे को लगता है ज़्यादा होगा, 8.5 plus होगा. In criteria तो रख देते हैं, लेकिन call नहीं आता 7.5 पे. मतलब मेरे को लगता है call will come only 8.5.
Sir, call. Yeah, sir, call came only 8 plus.
8 plus.
They set the criteria. Yeah, sir, 8 plus पे call आया. And sir, valid GATE score. They didn't set any cutoff.
Achha, they just took everyone. Did they ask you two questions? Yeah. First, why after BTech you want direct PhD? And second, why yes, aerospace? Did they ask you this?
Sir, aerospace question was asked in IIT Kanpur. In IIT Delhi, they asked why direct PhD. So I like really got prepared with this answer. Like I, because past few interviews, I like did some.
Had the same question.
Yeah, sir. So I got prepared with this answer. I like showed them my interest in research and everything. So they even asked me like, if you are a final year student, if you get placed in a company, so will you take and we offer you PhD. So which one will you take? So I mentioned them, sir, my life goal is to be an academician and a researcher. So I will definitely take PhD, sir, any day. So they were like that. And other than that, sir.
Go ahead. Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir. Other than that, they asked questions on the topic, sir. Like they asked me about 12 questions. And like this was an interview in which I answered all 12 correctly.
That's so, great.
Yeah, so how, that was a plus point, I guess.
Yes. Okay, so I will come to that part a little later, how you prepare. But Shivam, ek baat batao, how important is the research proposal?
Sir,
especially
research
for
proposal is important, sir, because I guess they, yeah, sir. Sir, they see like if what area they are working on and the person who is applying is also focusing to work on that same area. If that thing matches, sir, and also they check you on interview. So if everything matches with them and they feel confident about you, I feel they will then take you, sir.
That means referring to the work going on in IITs and then preparing really nicely for that, it helps, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You should go through every professor's profile and see like which professor works makes you like more interested in doing a PhD. Because everyone's work will not make you. Like for me, like solid mechanics, sir, I don't feel that inclined towards it. But when it comes to fluid mechanics, I'm totally inclined. So it's like that, sir.
Acha, now I'm coming to Shivam, that part of interview, I mean questions they asked you. How many professors were there and what kind of questions they asked you?
Sir, 7 professors, I guess, sir, total. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. 7 professors were there. And one main professor, he was coordinating all of them, like asking them to, now you can go and ask the questions like that. And all of the professors keep their cameras turned off, like the cameras are turned off, sir. Only one professor opened it when he was interacting with me. So that was it. And sir, they basically started with an introduction. So in introduction, I told about myself and everything. And then I mentioned about my final year project. So from there on, the question started. So the first question, sir, I actually just can't remember the question. So I made a list. Yeah, sir. So first question was like what you found out in the project. Like what was it that you found out? So I told them about that. It was a project on the efficiency of aircraft winglets. So, sir, I told them about that. Then, sir, from there, it's a very, like, if you ever say, if you are interested in aerodynamics, I guess every college will ask you this one question, how lift is generated. And 99% people give a wrong answer for this. Because most of the, like, Newton's third law and Bernoulli, they don't explain it fully. So, sir, I, from the potential flow theory, I applied the concept of circulation. And then I told, like, this is the full definition. With the help of circulation, we can explain the lift. So they were convinced with that answer, sir. Next, sir, that professor, he started asking me if you are interested in working in insect flight and bird flight. So I said, yeah, sir, that's a very good research topic and I would be interested. So he said, okay. Then, sir, from there, he asked me, like, what all you softwares you used in the project. So I told them I'm good at CATIA and Ansys Fluent. So they asked me like, okay, you have done any CFD course? From there it came to CFD, sir. I also mentioned CFD in my research area. So they asked me whether in undergraduation you have any CFD course or not. So I told them I don't have any CFD course, but I'm learning from some outside source and I've started in last week only. So they were only last week only. I said, yes, sir, only last week. So they were like, okay. And then, sir, they gave me a question like, if we have a computing power for only 10 total simulations and you need to find the most optimized design, how will you do it? So from the example only, I took like, I can vary the cant angle and the area of the profile and run 10 different simulations and whichever gives the better results, I can show that. So they were convinced. Then they asked, what is vorticity? Explain me. So I drew a diagram and showed it through the camera, sir. And then they asked me Navier-Stokes equation, and I told them. And then they asked, what if the Reynolds number is really high? What will happen to the Navier-Stokes equation? So here I got a bit confused. Then he just asked me, what is the Reynolds number definition? So from there, I got it. Like Reynolds number will be high, so viscous terms will be neglected. So there I got it and told them it will be converted to Euler's equation. So that's it, that. And then, sir, they asked me what will be the vorticity in boundary layer. Like, will the vorticity exist? And then what will be the condition of vorticity outside the boundary layer? So this was it, sir. And yeah, sir. Then last question was, second last question. It was like, what are you know about shocks? Shockwave, because I mentioned compressible flows. So they asked what are shocks, and I told them that yes sir, I know. Then they asked me what will be the variation of temperature, pressure, total temperature, total pressure across a normal shock. So I told them that, sir. And yeah sir, and one more question they asked. Yeah sir, in maths they asked like draw the graph of y is equals to sine x. I thought it will, why they are asking like such easy graph. Then I understood, like, they will add up to this question. Then they later said, now over it only draw y is equals to x. So I guess they were trying to check whether I'll intersect the curve at any point, but it will not intersect, sir. It will be like only passing through origin. So that was the thing, sir. And yeah, sir, these are the only questions which I remember, sir. And they kept asking me what are your research interests. Like they asked me hydrodynamic instability, or you are interested in working in experimental techniques or not. So I, for every whatever they asked, I said yes sir, I'm interested, because it was like whole topic of fluid mechanics. So that is it.
I believe it was very good interview, Shivam, for you, right? You could answer yes, the questions, and you must be satisfied at the end of the interview. Interview khatam kaise hua baad mein? What did they say?
Yes, yeah, sir. Like the last question, it was this maths question only, sir. And then they said, yeah, we are satisfied. And then they said, oh, it's okay, you can leave now. Okay. And like, that's also, they didn't say anything.
Shivam, you are going to join finally this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Chalo, congrats, Shivam, once again. And thanks a lot for sharing your experience with me. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.